Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the April 11th, 2021 service for First Congregational United Church of Christ in Zumbrota. It's so nice to see all of you here today. In the life of a church, there is absolutely nothing that is better than a baptism. It presents us with a great, great opportunity to consider our life and our faith and how we use that faith to move forward in our lives. Just a great opportunity. Thank you again for being here. Does anyone have any announcements that they'd like to make? Okay, would you please stand if you are able and bow your heads as I give the prayer of invocation. Jesus, thank you for your living water. Thank you for your care and love for us. Thank you for bringing us together to learn, to be together, to be inspired, and to follow the path you walked for a better world. Amen. Please join me in singing hymn 59, Holy Spirit Ever Dwelling. Please join me in singing hymn 325 in the Black Hymnal. We are only going to be singing verses 1, 2, and 3. Hymn 325, verses 1, 2, and 3. In the Gospel of Mark, we read that people were bringing little children to Jesus so that Jesus might touch the children. And the disciples, trying to keep the press of people away from Jesus, tried stopping them. And Jesus became angry at the disciples. He said, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them. For it is such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter." And he took them up in his arms, he laid his hands on them, and he blessed them. Jesus came to John to be baptized by him. John tried to make Jesus change his mind, saying, "I ought to be baptized by you." Jesus said, "Let it be so for now, for in that way we will do all that God requires." As soon as Jesus was baptized, he came up out of the water, and heaven was open, and the Spirit of God came down like a dove and landed on him.
Then a voice said from heaven, "This is my own dear Son, with whom I am well pleased."
Baptism is an outward sign of God's grace and love. This sign is for all of us. Baptism with water and the Holy Spirit is the mark of acceptance into the care of the church, participation in God's forgiveness, the beginning of their growth in faith and discipleship, and their joining our community. We are responsible for them now. Now, will the family and the sponsors come forward? Do you desire to have your child, Griffin Daniel Banner, baptized into the faith and family of Jesus? Do you promise according to the grace given to you to grow with Griffin in the Christian faith, to help be a faithful member of the church by furthering Jesus' mission in the world? If so, say yes, we do. And the sponsors, do you pledge that you will work with Griffin and Griffin's family in order to help raise Griffin into the life of the church and into the works that Jesus taught us? If so, say we do.
We do.
Now the congregation stand, please, if you are able. Do you, who witness and celebrate this sacrament, promise your care, love, and support for Griffin?
We promise our care, love, and support.
Water covered the earth at the beginning. People passed through the Red Sea waters to go from slavery to freedom. Jesus was baptized by John in the River Jordan. Jesus promised living water to the woman at the well. We take water for granted. It was not that way for people in the Bible. Water was precious to them. They knew that without water, there was no life. Jesus talked about the living water. In Minnesota, we have so much water, we take it for granted. Imagine what it was like in Palestine, in the desert, when they were so conscious of what water does and how we need water. Griffin Daniel Banner, I baptize you in the name of God and in the name of Jesus and in the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Look at how much
God loves us.
Thank you.
God's love is so obvious today.
May God bless you and keep you. May God's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may God give you peace. Amen. The prayer for the baptized. Holy One, Mother and Father of us all, we give thanks for Griffin and for Kylie and for Camden and for the grace present here in the water and in the spirit. Hold us all as in one household of love. Allow us to be friend, love, and nurture this family and each other.
Amen.
Amen. Please join me in singing hymn 328, Wonders of Wonder. Thank you for your work and your the future. And the other thing that I wanted to mention is that sometimes I like changing the words to hymns in my head. And then when I do that, it's kind of hard for Linda to follow along, and it's kind of hard for you to follow along, but that's all right. It's just my imagination working overtime and editing, thinking I can write these hymns better than other people, which I cannot. Now let's listen for the Word of God in the story from the Gospel of John on page 864 and 865 in the Pew Bible. It's the story of the woman at the well. Verses 1 through 15. Now when Jesus learned that the Pharisees had heard Jesus is making and baptizing more disciples than John, although it was not Jesus himself but his disciples who baptized, he left Judea and started back to Galilee. But he had to go through Samaria. So he came to a Samaritan city called Sychar, near the plot of ground that Jacob had given to his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there. And Jesus, tired out by his journey, was sitting by the well. It was about noon. A Samaritan woman came to draw water, and Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." His disciples had gone to the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jew, ask a drink of me, a woman of Samaria?" Jews do not share things in common with Samaritans. Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have no bucket, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our ancestor Jacob, who gave us the well, and with his sons and his flocks drank from it?" Jesus said to her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again, but those who drink of the water that I will give them will never be thirsty. The water that I will give will become in them a spring of water, gushing up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water so that I may never be thirsty or have to keep coming here to draw water." This ends the reading. I'd like you to put on your thinking caps now. Can you think of a living thing, plant, animal, anything, any living thing, can you think of any living thing that doesn't need water to grow? Can anyone think of anything, any living thing that doesn't use water to grow? I couldn't. We humans need water to grow. And I'm speaking literally. But I'm also speaking metaphorically. As we go about our day, and we go about our lives, and we do what we need to do in our life, earn a living, pay our mortgage, pay our rent, buy a car, drive to work. We need something extra, something a little bit extra in our lives. Sometimes when we are in a bad place or in a hard place, and many of us are there at times in our life, when we're in a hard place, we need someone to give us some water so that we can grow. Just recently, there have been a number of people who have given me that water that I need to grow. Jenny, Reverend Lisa Pressman, my teacher and chaplaincy, Scott McCray, and my mentor, David Tillman. I attended a lecture on counseling, and in this lecture, they asked this question. And it is a great question for everyone. The question is this: is this helping you to be who you want to be? Is this helping you to be who you want to be? Whatever it is. If we want to change, and if we want to grow, if we listen and pay attention, people come into our lives and we change. We change because of them. Let's think back to the woman at the well. If you take away the details later on, in the story, there are a lot of details about the woman and her life and Jesus' knowledge of that. But I'd like you for a few minutes to put that all aside and just focus on the story of one woman and one man and their interaction at the well. There are different cultures. Jewish man, Samaritan woman, and those cultures clashed and they didn't get along. So we have a person of different culture, people of different cultures. The woman wants to make a change in her life. She wants to make a change, but she's stuck. And that's something we all can relate to, being stuck, wanting something different, wanting to go forward, but we can't because we're stuck. Is this helping you to be who you want to be? We could ask the woman at the well. She says to Jesus, "Sir, give me this living water." She's saying, "I'm willing to change. I just need a little help." want something different in my life. This happened to her. Her interaction with a strange man who was not in her culture, Jesus. If you look back at your life, and you think about a teacher, or a grandparent, or a parent, or a girlfriend, or a boyfriend, or a husband, or a wife, someone who came into your life and said something that you needed to hear. That doesn't only happen in the Bible, it happens today to us. And if we look back, we can find those instances where we heard something that we really needed to hear. Maybe it was something we knew already. Deep down inside, we had a little plant. But that plant needed some water to grow. And once it got that water, the plant grew, and we grew. The story of the woman in the well is frequently interpreted as Jesus changing this woman's life. I think that that's possible. I think there are some other lessons that we can take from that. Another lesson we can take from that is that Jesus was a person who entered this woman's life and told her something that she needed to hear, and she changed. Jesus didn't change her. She changed because of what Jesus told her. She gave Jesus a gift too. And that isn't often said. But when I read the story, that's what I saw, is the gift that she gave to Jesus. And it was a tremendous gift that she gave Jesus. She gave Jesus the knowledge that his words, and maybe just his presence, his being with her, was enough to change her life. Just being with her was enough to change her life. And the moral of the story is this: that Jesus isn't the only one who can change people's life like that. We all, everyone here, we all can do that. What an honor. Responsibility. Thanks be to God. Amen. Sometimes coincidences happen in this world. Brittany was telling me that she wanted to sing this hymn today, and it was already in the program. Please join me in singing hymn 327. Jesus loves you. We have a wonderful opportunity to talk about our joys that we have and the things that we're grateful for and any concerns or troubles that we have. We might be able to lend a hand. So if there's anything you'd like to say, anything you'd like to bring to all of us loving people, please do so.
I know I've messaged you, JD, but I just want to put my sister, Nicole, and then my nephew, Milo, in our prayers. He was born 9 weeks early. He's doing good. So I just want to keep them all in our prayers.
Thank you. Nicole and Milo. Is there anything else?
I want to say thank you for allowing us to be here today for Griffin's baptism. It's a beautiful thing to be a part of, so thank you.
Yeah, thanks for being here and sharing that. They're just tremendous. They're awe-inspiring, I think. Seeing all this new life and energy. I wish you could harness some of it for some of us that are a little bit farther down the road. Would you bow your heads, please, for the prayers of the people? Holy One, thank you for letting us be together and letting us share the love and the life that is here. Thank you for loving us so much to bless us in this way. We pray for our friends who cannot join us regularly on Sunday mornings. We ask that you lift up and strengthen those who suffer in silence, that they may have the courage to reach out for help or companionship. We pray for everyone affected by COVID-19, especially for those people who feel like They were alone and apart from everyone else. Heal them and strengthen them until the time that we can be together the way we used to. We are grateful, God, for those who seek the light and remain resilient in COVID-19. Please allow their example to spread so that we all can have a little bit more optimism and a little bit more hope and a little bit more perseverance. We pray for faith and wisdom for our country's leaders. We pray for Deb, our former janitor who is recovering. God, please care for the family of Dan King, who died on Friday. Comfort all who loved him. And encourage them to continue living and helping us in our journey. And show us a way for us to be able to help them. We pray for Connie Hawley's parents, Dwayne and Ruth. As they move in this stage of their lives, we pray for Gary Austin. Please continue to give him healing grace, God. We pray for Bill Lynn's friend who has COVID-19. And we pray for Dan who has COVID-19. Encourage them and give them evidence of your power and your ability to heal. We also pray for Nicole and Milo. Give them the ability to continue to thrive and grow in your beautiful world. Please join me in praying as Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now please stand if you are able, and let us wave or gesture to each other, and let each other know how much love there is here, and how much we mean to each other. On the inside back cover of the black hymnal is the peace song, and let us sing that. Bill, it looks to me as if Camden took your cowboy hat. Fits him just perfectly. I think you probably have lost a cowboy hat now. You have a spare, don't you? I thought that you might.
Thank you.
Go with God.